Today I plan to discuss four important concepts for time, right? How do you express time? Now, in different languages, there are different facilities, different ways you can express time. For example, if you take Hindi, then hai indicates present time, tha indicates past time, hoga indicates future time, right? So, in English also, there are different devices, certain strategies using which we can express time. So, today let's discuss four basic concepts. Okay. The first, very simple, is time. Usually in English, we use either a form of to be or the verb form itself to express time. For example, if this is my time diagram and if this is my present point of time now, and if I want to say something about now, then I can use am, is, are. We are here at Fluentlingua, right? You are here, he is here, we are here. So normally am, is, are, they tell you the time. Present time, now. When we want to talk about a past point of time, we use was or were. Yesterday at this time, I was here. We were here, right? And when we talk about future point of time, then we say shall or will and be. So, shall be or will be. So, tomorrow at this time, we will be here. Right? So, normally forms of, these are all forms of to be. They give you either present time or past time or future time. Sometimes the verb form itself can also tell you time. As you know, we have speak, spoke, spoken, write, wrote, written, go, went, gone. Right? So, in a verb, in a sentence, suppose I say went. So, you know that it generally refers to past time. I went to Mumbai yesterday. I wrote a letter an hour ago. So, when we have a past point of time, we use went. So, verb form itself can also tell you the time, right? So, that is our time concept. Another concept is continuity. Something that is continuous, some action which is going on. It can be present, past or future. Continuity can be at any point of time. Now, to express continuity in English, we have the ing form of the verb. You know that, writing, speaking, dancing, jumping, right? Now, ing gives you continuity, but again you have to give time. And for time, we already have a form of to be. So, we can use a form of to be before continuity expression. So, when I say I am teaching, that means my teaching process is going on now. We are talking about English. So, time, now, action, teach, and ing, continuity. Exactly the same thing will happen in the past. Yesterday at this time, I was teaching. So, again, was past time, other things are the same. And the same thing will happen in the future also. In future at this time, tomorrow at this time, I, then time future will be, and action teach, and continuity ing. So, tomorrow at this time, I'll be teaching. Right? So, that is our continuity concept. The third concept is perfection. Perfection, it can be interpreted as completion of an action, right? So, completion of an action, again we can think about three different time points. The completion of an action can be before now, completion of an action can be before a past point of now, past point. It can be before a future point of time, right? Completion can be here, here or here. So, with reference to some point, we are talking about completion. And in English, to convey that completion of an action, or when we talk about the result of an action, we say, we use a form of have followed by a past participle. That is the third form of the verb, right? So, here have, that means it can be has, it can be have, it can be had, it can be will have, depending on the time. So, for example, some action was over in the past and the result has still some impact on the present time. So, for that we say, I have, say, written a letter. Okay, so when we say I have written a letter, that means the action was over in the past, but the result of that action has some impact on the present time. When you say I have seen the Taj Mahal, that means you remember seeing it, right? So, past action but with present result. Here the focus is on result, not on time. When I say I have written a letter, you know that the action was over, but you don't know when. We cannot use time here, right? Now, think about a similar situation, but in the past. Yesterday, for example, you came to my house at 8 o'clock and I wrote a letter at, say, 7 o'clock. So, when I compare these two things, these two actions, then the first action was writing a letter. So, out of two actions, for the first past action, we use past perfect. So, I had written a letter. Now, when I say I had written a letter, that means completion before a past point of time. So, I have to give that past time. So, I have to say before what? Before you came. Right? So, here we just say I have written a letter because the reference point is now. This is present perfect. But here we have to give the reference point. I had written a letter before you came. The train had left before he reached the platform. The patient had died before the doctor came. So, here we have two reference points actually. And before this, this action had taken place. Right? Now, something similar will happen in the future. In the future, this is our reference point, FT. And we imagine the completion of an action before that point comes. So, for example, right now it is 7 o'clock. I have started some work. I have started writing a letter. And I imagine that it will take about 30 minutes, 40 minutes, 45 minutes. But in any case, before 8 o'clock, I intend to complete that work. So, what will I say here? This completion of an action, I will have, okay, I will have written a letter, okay, I will have written a letter before 8 o'clock, or you can say before he comes. Okay, you can give this reference point in any way. You must have noticed that here to give this future reference point, we use the simple present tense, before he comes. In the past, we use the simple past tense, before you came, right? And here we use the simple present tense. Now you can compare, I have written a letter, that means your reference point is now. I had written a letter before you came, so reference point is past, and I will have written a letter before this future point of time comes, right? So, this is your perfect concept, perfection, clear? Now, the next concept is a combination of second and third. That means it is perfect also and it is continuous also. Both these are together. Now, if it is perfect, then it requires a form of have. And if it is continuous, it requires the ing form. Right? Now, if it is continuous, it requires ing form, and before ing form you require a form of to be. And if it is perfect, then you require have, and after that you require a past participle. That means here you want something which is to be and the past participle, that means being. So now you can see this part is perfect and this part is continuous. That means it is perfect continuous, right? That is the structure. But what about the meaning? The meaning is continuity, but over a period of time. Here when I say I am teaching to be form I am teaching, that means I am talking about only present point of time. But suppose I want to say past to present time and continuity, then I require this tense. So suppose I started teaching at 4 o'clock. Right now it is say 4:30. So what can I say? I have been teaching. So when I say I have been teaching, that means I am talking about a period of time. Not just I am teaching now, but I have been teaching. Now I have two possibilities. I can give the beginning point using since. So I have been teaching since 4 o'clock, or I can say I have been teaching, period of time is 4, so for half an hour, right? So I am teaching now, that's okay, but I have been teaching for half an hour. It is raining now, that's fine, but it has been raining for 2 hours, right? I am working in this company, that's okay, but I have been working in this company for 5 years. So now you can compare these two. Here continuity, here also continuity, but here continuity at a point of time and here continuity over a period of time. The same thing can happen in the past also, right? When she came, we were discussing point of time. Sorry, but when she came, we had been discussing for 20 minutes, right? When you came, I was writing, but when you came, I had been writing for 2 hours, right? So again, past continuous and past perfect continuous, that's the difference. I was writing, I had been writing. The same thing will happen in the future. I will be writing, point of time, I will have been writing, period of time. Right? So these are the four concepts. Time will revise very quickly. We express time in English using a form of to be. Present time, MSR, past time, was, were, future time, shall be, will be, generally. We express continuity with the ing form. And before we express continuity, we have to give time. So continuity, but when? Now, MSR, or past, was, were, or future, shall be, will be. Then perfection, that means completion. So completion before now. So you can see before present, present perfect, before past, past perfect, and before future, future perfect. But all these three require a form of have. Has have, or had, or will have. And all these three are followed by the past participle, which is actually the third form of the verb, right? So write, wrote, written. Written is the third form. Go, went, gone. Gone is the third form. And as we discussed, when you use this tense for present perfect, time is not given. I have seen the Taj Mahal, that's it. Because when you give time, you require the simple past tense. I saw the Taj Mahal in 1995. I have written a letter, fine. But I wrote it half an hour ago. So present perfect, then past perfect, something had happened before a past point of time, and future perfect, something will have happened before a future point of time. And the fourth is a combination of 2 and 3. It is perfect also and it is continuous also. And the pattern is fixed. Any form of have, depending on the time, then been and continuity, ing form. Right? So these are the four basic concepts for tense system. Any questions?